Hey YouTube family, thanks for joining us today. It is the beginning of October and we have got a lot to do around the homestead here. The snow is going to start flying before you know it, and we have so many things to accomplish before that happens. And yet it seems like our weekends are getting away from us really, really fast. So we need to be very intentional about what we're going to be doing to get those projects done. So what I want to do today is just take you around to a couple of things we're doing in the garden and show you what's happening and show you what we want to accomplish, as well as show you some of the things that we want to do with our fall garden, as well as potentially turning it into an early winter or winter garden also. So come along for the ride today. It's not going to take very long, and hopefully it'll give you some ideas what to do with your own garden this fall too. All right, so about a month ago, we ended up planting some carrots, some radishes, and that radish, we had a whole row of radish, and when we came back from vacation, they were huge. If you follow us on Instagram, you saw a photo of those. They almost looked like beets. They were so big. We've just got a couple left. We're going to replant those radish. We've thinned out the carrots. A lot of the different varieties of lettuce we planted did not germinate and come up. We think either the seeds were too old, or potentially it was still just too hot here in Southwest Ohio. I mean, we just got done with a 90 plus degree weather a week ago. We had a little bit better germination rate. Now, this might not look the best, but we've been cutting on this. I think we've done two, maybe three cuttings already on this box since we've been back from vacation at the end of September. So about a week, and we've already cut this two to three times. Again, you can see where we had some failure in germination, but we'll tell you what we're going to be doing with that. We also, just over this last week, finally took some reclaimed wood, made a box, painted it, and raised that box up. And so now we've got to end up filling that box up, because in that box and in that box are going to be going our garlic and onions. Or actually, we're probably going to be putting the onions there, and we're going to be putting the garlic there. I ended up putting some black tarp down to try to sterilize the box, kill the weeds. If you can see there, I mean, it looks fantastic. About 3 weeks of that, and there were no weeds left whatsoever. So what we're going to do is we've ordered some more seeds from Johnny's Select Seeds. There will be a link below in the description where you can order those. And we're going to be putting in cold weather or fall planted lettuce and spinach, and we're going to plant more radish, and we're probably not going to plant the carrot because we have long season carrot, not short season carrot. And so we're just going to go ahead and let these continue to grow. But if you look right down here, I've gone out and bought some 10 foot lengths of half inch PVC. And what we're going to be doing is taking those and constructing a hoop system to go over these three boxes. Now, I'm sterilizing that box right now. Again, we really enjoy being able to eat fresh greens, and we've never grown them too much past the fall, and we really want to see how long we can extend our season. And so we're going to construct kind of a mini greenhouse, and we'll see what happens. Also, our late season cabbage is going just gangbusters. Our tomatoes are starting to come to an end. And that fall box, that far box, which we've struggled with for a long, long time, is kind of petering out itself, and we'll end up getting that also ready for bed. But let me show you what we're going to end up putting on top of this this hoop. All right, what we ended up doing was we ended up ordering row covers. I'll show that to you here in just a moment. We ended up ordering a row cover from Johnny's Selected Seeds several weeks ago that was on sale for $16. It was a deal we just couldn't pass up. It was a great, great deal. And so we ended up ordering something that was more than just a little row cover. It's a little bit more robust. It is the Agribon AG19 row cover. It comes in 50 foot lengths, 10 feet wide, and it will protect the plants down to 28 degrees. And so what we're hoping to do is to get our plants and use this to protect our plants well into mid-fall or later. Now, as the temperatures continue to drop and as temperatures are going to consistently stay below freezing,
What we'll end up doing on a warm day or our last warm day before it gets below freezing is to cover those same boxes with plastic, with greenhouse plastic, and we'll be using that as well as some other methods to try to keep the plants warm as long as we can. And who knows, if we're able to keep these boxes producing into December, that would be fantastic. But again, I just couldn't pass this up. It was a great deal. They had different lengths, different styles of row covers that were between $16 and $30, depending on how wide and how long they were.
Now, how we're going to build that hoop house is by taking 3/4-inch PVC, and we're going to be cutting it into 5-inch lengths, putting two sets of holes in it that go all the way through. One hole is going to have a larger diameter on the outside, and the other one is going to have just the same diameter. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to drive a screw through that top hole that seats itself on the far side of this PVC against the outside, that 2x4 running along the corner of those boxes. And then the other screw is going to go through, but its head is going to seat on the outside diameter of the bottom part of that PVC. What I'm hoping it will do is it will keep the PVC from driving all the way through the bottom of this PVC and then coming out the other side and possibly lowering or collapsing the box. Now, what I'm going to be putting inside this is the 1/2-inch diameter PVC that you saw laying out there in the garden. I had a lot of extra pieces of 3/4 PVC, and I've actually already started cutting that and getting some of that ready, but you're going to see that completed project in another video. And here's what I mean by that. This is an example of that. I've got a hole, and let me see if I can get it put up there. I've got a hole drilled all the way through, so both sides, and I've got that same diameter hole also drilled there. However, I went back with another drill bit and drill a larger diameter hole. So that will allow the head of the one screw to pass all the way through, seat itself on the inside of that hole. However, this hole here at the bottom will then end up providing the ability for a longer screw to go all the way through, except for the head to seat itself on the outside. And so again, we'll see if this works or not. I'm not a mechanical engineer by any means. I don't work with wood. I'm just a home do-it-yourselfer kind of guy. And so we'll see what we run into. But again, by doing this, we hope to extend our season and continue to enjoy a lot of those fresh greens. Because I'll just be honest, when it comes to what's money worthy, we save a lot of money by growing our own tomatoes and some of the things that we grow. We can get cheaper at the market. However, we know where ours come from when we grow them, but we do save a lot of money by growing our own greens, our own tomatoes, our own carrots. A lot of the vegetables that we have, we can buy, we can grow cheaper than we can buy them at the store. So again, a lot of things going on here. I know Lynn was showing you some of the projects that we were doing earlier in one of our garden reviews. Let me just take a moment to show you some of the things that we've accomplished. Here is the finished wood rick. This measures approximately, oh my goodness, I think this is approximately 6 foot long by about almost 5.5, 6 foot tall. And we've already used some of the wood across the top here. We've been burning some wood since we've gotten back from vacation. That 90 degree weather is gone, and now it's into the low 50s, upper 40s at night, and it's really nice to sit out by there. But what's nice is, other than these 2x4s that came up on the side, all of this wood, other than the tin roof and those side pieces of wood, are all upcycled lumber. There was somebody getting rid of a lot of lumber, and we went ahead and took that, and we took screws out, and we did a number of things to reclaim it, and it really has helped us add some value to our life here. Those strawberry boxes that Lynn had showed you in another video, let me walk and show you those. Those were also made of upcycled lumber. And so these boxes haven't cost us anything other than maybe the stain, but the stain we've had for several years, and because we used it to stain the deck back 8 years ago when we moved here. And so again, all of this is upcycled lumber. Now, if you see, the strawberries are doing really, really well. As a matter of fact, we're actually even getting some late season strawberries. Look at that, isn't that awesome? Now, we're not gonna get enough out of these boxes because most of these are June bearing. Only a couple of the plants are ever bearing, but we've got enough to pull off and eat, and it just, I know, kind of delights
Again,
us.
Lots of projects we're getting done here in the homestead. So we hope that you enjoyed this short update. If you did, hit the like button. If you haven't yet subscribed to our channel, we would certainly love it if you would subscribe. And then if you would like to know when a new video comes out, because we're not as regular as we would like to be, because this is not what we do for a living, just go ahead and hit that bell button. And then when we post a new video, it will let you know when it's out. Again, thank you for joining us today here on Simple Homesteading. You have a great day.